In the first part of our tutorial for Mode 2, we used audio as a signal source. Now, let's see what we can do with control voltages. Here, we have a basic one-note sequence with a pulse wave going through a resonant low-pass filter. We'll now utilize sequence 1 to route different CVs to the cutoff CV input of the filter module. Let's hook up Civilization with some control voltages. Input 1 is getting an LFO signal. Input 2, an audio rate triangle wave. We're also feeding some white noise into input 3, while input 4 is getting a burst signal from the Wogglebug module. We'll now set up a sequence to switch through the four inputs, as well as a steady CV and a random CV, both generated by Civilization. Remember, each step can be individually adjusted for its gain value, allowing for even more variation in your sequence. By the way, both the steady CV and the random CV step type have a default range of 0 to plus 3 volts DC. However, they can be extended up to plus 10 volts DC as an expert feature. Paired with the step gain function, you can turn Mode 2 into a classic 8-step sequencer with adjustable voltage gain per step. Now, let's take a look at the configuration pages for Mode 2. For the most part, they're the same as in Mode 1 and 3, with some exceptions. Here's an example patch. Let's use an analog step sequencer as a pitch CV source for a VCO module. The step sequencer's CV output is connected to Civilization's input 1. A rapidly changing random CV, aka woggle signal, is fed into input 2, and finally, an LFO signal into input 3. By default, quantization is off, so it's no wonder that our sequence sounds a little out of tune. Let's fix that. From the performance page, long pressing the left-hand encoder 1, 2, or 3 takes us to the first configuration page. The first item, selected by pressing the blue encoder, is the quantization page. Here we can choose between 9 quantization scales for each of the 4 outputs. Let's turn the first right-hand encoder to choose a scale for our sequence. Now we're entering melodic territory. Pressing the yellow encoder will take us to the clock and trigger source page. By default, all 4 sequences are set to receive their clock signal from the CVA input, and that's what we're using here as well. For your trigger source, you can choose various combinations of CVA and CVB input, or bus gate. On the same config page, you can enable or disable sample and hold individually for all 4 outputs. When activated, the inputs are sampled at each clock interval. The right-hand LEDs will give you visual feedback when sample and hold is activated. Press the salmon-colored encoder to enter the clock division page. Here, you can configure a clock divider for each of the 4 sequences. By default, it's set to 1, meaning each clock tick advances the sequence by 1 step. Alternatively, you can set it to factor 2, 4, or 8. Please note that in Mode 2, the clock divider only affects the sequencer and not the sample and hold processor. In the clock division page, pressing any of the right-hand encoders lets you reset the clock on the fly. The reset will occur at the next clock or trigger event. Pressing the bottom left-hand encoder switches over to the configuration page 2. The light green encoder will take you to the glide time page. Here, you can adjust glide or portamento individually for each output. push the Magento encoder to enter the CVB function page. Here you can customize what the CVB input does if it's not already acting as the clock source for the sequencer. Your first option is resetting the sequence to step 1 when CVB receives a trigger or gate signal. This can be used to great effect when you use a random gate or any other fluctuating or stepped voltage. The reset will always occur at the next clock cycle. Alternatively, you can use CVB to select the quantization scale, or to activate and deactivate the glide function. Last but not least, pressing the dark green encoder lets you configure the playback direction for each sequence. By default, it's set to forward. You can also set it to reverse, make it go zigzag, or play in random order. Let's wrap this up, because your head must be spinning by now. I know mine is. We've got more videos explaining the other modes, as well as demos showcasing some advanced tricks, all that's possible with Civilization. So stay tuned and subscribe to our channel. Bye for now.